The answer to the statewide problem can be found right now in a small area off the west side of the Big Island, where the community is going back to its roots. Sam Spangler joins us now with more on this story. Sammy.
That's right, Dash. It's been a community effort. Generations of leaders in Kupuna devised a plan to replenish their dwindling reef fish population. No fishing for 10 years. Now, according to scientists, the results on a nearly 4-mile stretch of coast named Ka'upelehu have been astonishing.
We just got back from doing 2 weeks of surveys. We jumped in the water at over 100 different sites. And pretty much every time we got out of the water, we just all looked at each other and said, wow, there's a lot more fish out there.
The moratorium on reef fishing is called Try Wait and was implemented back in 2016. It is very similar to traditional Hawaiian fishing practices of closed seasons and areas.
The goal has been the long-term sustainable harvest from this area for the people that live there. And so the goal has always been to restore and replenish these resources to enable long-term sustainable harvest for generations to come. So that's why they call it try wait. It's just try wait for a few more years to allow the resources to rest and recover.
Increases in populations have been seen in Manini, Uhu, and Kole, among others.
There's still 7 more years to go. There's still a lot of recovery to be had, but only 3 years in, we are seeing piles of fish in places that 3 years ago we saw very few. The reef is responding really quickly and really well, and it's really fantastic to be able to share that with the community.
The DLNR enforced program could be an answer to declining reef fish populations across the state, with the only other current program in Haena on Kauai.
Ka'upelehu is one of the only 2 communities that has navigated all the way through that process so far, but there's a number of other communities that are in various steps along the way and very motivated to get rules in place for their place as well.
I also asked Dr. Conklin if the replenishment brought any predators like sharks. He said not anything to worry about, but he was encouraged by finding some gray reef sharks, which used to be prominent in the area. Bridget?